Gonna build a mountain from a little hill. Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is Delay Designer, and we are back with another speed build video of Meilin Zoo, our sandbox park. And as mentioned in my last live stream, I wanted to build a African wild dog habitat with some kind of rock bridge over the path. And it's finally working, because if you remember when I was talking about the orangutan habitat with having like poles over the path, and it just didn't work because the people, as soon as they walked over the null fence, and then you had like something above it where the animals could basically not escape from, they still would feel like being endangered of a dangerous species, so they ran away, and it just didn't really work. But I think with the last update or anything like that, it finally works, so you can now have just a flat path on the terrain, and then have something above it where what the animals can use as a bridge, or maybe a climbing frame if you're making it for an orangutan or anything like that. So that is really cool, so I'm really happy this is basically just working easier than I thought. Like, the workaround would have been that you just lower the terrain and make some kind of bridge of your path so the people would still feel safe. But yeah, we don't have to do that right now, so that is really cool. So we can now finally create something going over the path where the animals can use as a bridge, which is actually really cool. So I decided to create this African wild dog habitat because I just really love those guys. They are so cute and so beautiful. Their fur is really lovely. And basically the biggest area of this habitat was not big enough for them. So that was the reason why I wanted to combine two areas on both sides of the path. And I'm really happy with how this one turned out. So I really tried to do a little bit like normal real life zoos would do, with like the hired terrain, or at least going down in a slope, but the people, if they are walking over the bridge, can still see the animals like everywhere where they are. And on the other side you have the rocky bridge, and underneath it you have the shelter. Of course, on both sides you have shelters now, and the people can look inside of it with the one-sided glass. And then if you go closer to the House of Primates, which we recently finished, then you still have two sides with the chain link fence. And yeah, I'm just really happy with how this one turned out. It was a little bit of a struggle. Like, the African wild dog can jump pretty high, so I really had to pay attention to how high I put my rocks and those kind of things. But yeah, we managed to have a habitat now where the African wild dog is not able to escape, so that is really cool. And they actually use everything, and I just really love that. You see them really running from one side to the other side over the bridge, which is just a lot of fun. I tried to capture that a little bit in the cinematic shot, so hopefully you guys will enjoy that. I did try to get some puppies in, but obviously when I look at them, they don't want to have any puppies. So they did play a lot, but they didn't do any breeding so far, so yeah. I will keep that for a later stage again, but I'm just really excited to see some puppies running around in this habitat and just have some fun. So at first I thought maybe I wanted to create that bridge from rocks out of terrain, but I really found out very quickly that if you use the terrain and like the shape tool, you can really easily create some kind of tunneling. But it was just way too high, and since the guests still walk underneath it if you put down some rocks, and also the animals have no issues to walk over it, I decided to go for rocks instead. But the only downside is, like, if you use terrain, you can really use the fencing of the game to create those barriers. But now I had to create some fencing myself. Like, I didn't want it to be completely out of rocks, so in the end I ended up with using some fencing from the construction building items. But we don't really have that many nice looking fences, so you always end up with the same steel fences. So yeah, that's the only downside. I didn't want to use wood for this because I just didn't feel like that would fit better. I really wanted to have something with steel, but maybe
There are items that I haven't figured out yet that you where you can also create some really cool fencing of. But yeah, for now we just stick with those steel fencing we use a lot during the game. But I really hope we will get some kind of fences like the chain link fences or anything like that that you can really just put down. Because that will be really amazing that you have just, like for every fence, like from the wood you have like a whole set of wall pieces that fit the same theme, but we don't really have that with other things other than maybe the concrete. So I really would love to see some chain fence and those kind of things also added as just separate items for building. So yeah, I'm really hoping that in the future we will get an update or a DLC where we will see some more of those items. But I do feel that should be in a free update though, because I feel that just belongs to the base game and not something you have to buy a DLC for, obviously. But yeah, I just really love the look of those chain link fences. They look so gorgeous. I used them earlier at the Ringtailed Lemur house where what was inspired by the London Gorilla House, if I remember correctly. And I used it a lot just as a decoration item, and those fences are just really beautiful. So yeah, I was really happy to use it again a little bit in this area. And we also have some facility buildings in the back, which I really tried to just hide away a little bit with some elephant grass and those kind of things. I don't really think the African wild dog in this habitat is super happy with the amount of plants. I try to limit it as much as possible, but the African wild dog just doesn't really like it. Because I wanted to hide away the facility building stuff, I really try to create some kind of fencing with the elephant's grass. So I don't really think they really liked it, but I didn't really check it because now I'm playing in sandbox mode, and recently they got an update where you could just check that your animals have 100% welfare no matter what you do. So I don't really check those kind of things anymore because I'm like, yeah, well, I just want to make it look pretty and nice. And they still have like a very big open space where they can just run around, and they do run about a lot. So I think they still are really happy with it, even though maybe I used a little bit too many trees and the elephant grass. What is really weird though, the elephant grass has some kind of walkable area on top of it. So I tried to use that as grass at some points and they were just walking over it in the sky. So I was like, that doesn't look right. So I had to move and tweak it a little bit in the end to make it look a bit more natural. And one was even sleeping on it and I was like, what are you doing? And he was just like sleeping in the sky above elephant grass. And I was like, what? It was so funny. But yeah, other than that, it's all working super nice. And it's just so much fun to see this zoo coming along quite nicely. I think only just a few more episodes, guys, and we're finished. And if you're wondering for a zoo tour, I know a lot of people ask for it. I did a zoo tour during my live stream I had last Saturday where we celebrated my 60,000 subscribers, which I'm still super thankful of. So thank you guys so much. If you haven't been there, I can't believe it. I'm just super thankful that we hit 60,000 subscribers, and I just really never expected this to happen this soon. So yeah, thank you guys so much for that, of course. But yeah, if you're looking for a zoo tour, definitely go and check out that live stream. The Malin zoo tour was at the end of the live stream, and before that I did some tours of all my Planet Coaster parks I've made during the times I played a lot of Planet Coaster, and hopefully I can get back to Planet Coaster. I think beginning of next year, I wanna try to see if I can get back to it a little bit, but no guarantees. But yeah, if you're interested to see my parks, like from my very, very first park in Planet Coaster Alpha to my very last park and Koali Beach, so definitely then go and check out that live stream or just scroll through it a little bit so you can see some tweaks of it. And yeah, as I said, the Mainland Zoo tour was really a lot of fun, so hopefully you guys enjoyed who were there or have seen it later. But thanks in general everyone that watched the video or has been there. Thank you for all your congratulations, and you guys are really amazing, so thank you guys so much for that. So yeah, the only downside of this habitat is still that I can't move the water section. For those who are wondering why I don't do anything with the river that is on the side, I just can't move the water anymore. I can't remove it and then put the water back. I don't know what that is, because basically not an animal is able to really use it except for the Bengal tigers, but even though I box all the animals, it's still not working properly, so I just have to stick with that river, unfortunately. And it doesn't look annoying or anything like that. The only downside is just that you really have to work with the river that is on that spot and not being able to tweak it a little bit. So yeah, we have to live with that. Do let me know in the comment section what you guys think of this new habitat for the African wild dog. Leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed, and subscribe of course if you already haven't. And I just really hope to see you guys in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye guys. Thank you.